The following is a production of the Ottumwa Radio Group Sports Network. Ottumwa Baseball is coming your way on 1240 AM and 102.7 FM KBIZ. Ottumwa Bulldogs sports broadcasts are brought to you by these sponsors. Black Hawk Auto Body, by Champion Bowl in Ottumwa, by Citizens Mutual, by Cole Palace Cafe and Books, by Community First Credit Union, by Lee's Photography, by Lisco, by Mercy One Ottumwa Family and Internal Medicine Clinic, by Meridian Credit Union, by Mike's Pizza and Steakhouse, by the Ottumwa Job Corps Center, by Petrito Orthodontics, by Reflection Studio, by Schroeder Graphics, by Shelter Insurance, and by Slayton Polaris. Now, let's get you to the field with the voice of your Ottumwa Bulldogs, Jason Van Arkel.
Ottumwa High Baseball is on the air. Good afternoon, everybody. From Barton Field on the campus of Urbandale High School, Jason Van Arkel reporting. Annie Argo, the on-site video producer. Brandon Drew, the radio producer, back at the KBIZ studios. It's an out-of-metro conference, but heavy-hitting CIML baseball doubleheader as your 16-3 Ottumwa Bulldogs take on Class 4A, number 10, Urbandale, the Jayhawks. OHS comes in red hot. We've won 9 in a row and coming off an absolute thumping last night on the road of Des Moines Roosevelt, beating the Rough Riders 16-1 in 6 innings and then 14-2 in 5 innings. Urbandale has kind of been up and down, but they got back on their feet last night by sweeping West Des Moines Valley 16-2 and 5-0. And Urbandale began the year ranked 2nd in the state. They have slipped a little bit down to number 10. Meanwhile, Ottumwa knocking on the door of the top 10. And a win or two tonight would probably be the breakthrough for Ottumwa getting into the top 10 in Class 4A in the Iowa High School Baseball Coaches Association poll. Ottumwa's history here at Barton Field hasn't been good. You go back to 2010 in this series, Ottumwa just 4-11 against the Jayhawks. And Urbandale has won the last 8 meetings between the two teams. That includes that heartbreaking 2016 sub-state final played right here. Ottumwa and Urbandale went to the 7th in a scoreless tie. Parker Thode pitched a great game for the Bulldogs. Bradley Bramschreiber helped put Ottumwa in front with a driving home a run with a double in the top of that 7th inning. And the Bulldogs got the first out in the bottom of the 7th, only to see Urbandale scratch and claw their way to 2 runs without ever hitting the ball really hard. But Urbandale scored 2 in the bottom of that 7th inning to clinch a trip to state at Ottumwa's expense. And the two programs have kind of gone a different direction since then. Ottumwa has yet to get back to a sub-state final, while Urbandale went to state in 2016. They came up short in 2017. Then they won the Class 4A state championship 2018 and 2019. And last year, 2020, they made it back to the state semifinals. So for Ottumwa tonight, a chance to maybe get back to the level they were toe-to-toe with Urbandale in 2016 and hopefully get ahead of the Jayhawks. Again, Urbandale number 10, Bulldogs also receiving votes. And Urbandale, they're still a good baseball team, but they've scuffled against the elite. They're 2-7 combined against number 1 Johnston, number 3 Dowling, number 5 Ankeny, number 7 Waukee, and number 9 Lewis Central. Ottumwa split with Waukee, as has Urbandale, so Bulldogs feel like they're right there. They feel like they can get a win or two here tonight against the Jayhawks. The head coaches, John Yeager for Ottumwa, Jeremy Heinen for Urbandale, are headed out to talk to the umpires right now. Let's take a 2-minute timeout and come back with the starting lineups on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Summer is the time to make every moment count. So pack more toys with bigger hauling and towing capacity. Go social outdoor style, connect with your friends, and turn up your soundtrack to make your rides even more epic. Because conquering summer is about capturing every second of adventure. Polaris. Think outside.
Stop into Slayton Polaris, located 8 miles south and west of Pulaski.
It's time to choose the credit union with a new perspective. At Meridian Credit Union, we don't just see member profiles. We see people. People with goals. People who want to save more. People that we can help. That's why we offer financial services convenient to you. Great loan rates, online banking with bill pay, mobile banking, and credit cards. Join the many satisfied Meridian members today. See how our perspective can help you.
Meridian Credit Union, where it feels like home.
Hi, I'm Dr. Dwayne Petrito, your orthodontist in Ottumwa and Oskaloosa. Many of our patients are playing in this game, and we want you to know we are happy to see you representing your school and playing hard. If you haven't been in to see us yet, please call our office for an appointment. Your first appointment is always free. From start to finish, we are here for you every step of the way. We specialize in giving you a great smile and bite. We look forward to seeing you soon. Our team is cheering for you in today's game.
Seasons change. Our priorities change. Your financial needs change. But there's one thing that remains consistent. Our dedication to making your financial life easier. Together. So let's get to know each other. Because together is better.
Watching the Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Ottumwa High Baseball on KBIZ and on the live video stream. Big doubleheader on the road tonight at Urbandale. Let's get you the starting lineups for game one. First for Ottumwa, leading off and playing right field, Blaze Rominger. Batting second, the shortstop, Mitch Wood. Jesus Jaime at third base bats third. And Adam Greiner, the designated hitter, batting cleanup. Trey Swartz at first base batting fifth. Carter Thompson, the second baseman, will hit sixth. Max Thomason is the starting pitcher. He bats seventh. Tanner Shark in left field batting eighth. Batting ninth is the center fielder, Colton McKinnon. And in the field, but not in the batting order, is the catcher, Adam Denniston. Thomason on the mound, the senior right-hander, getting his third start, his fourth appearance. He is 2-0 with a 3.89 ERA, nine innings pitched, eight hits allowed, five runs all earned, one walk, two hit batters, 11 strikeouts, and opponents hitting 216 against Max. As for the Urbandale lineup, their head coach Jeremy Heinen sending out Greg Christensen leading off and catching. Drew Dykstra, the center fielder, bats second. Dylan Kuhl, the designated hitter, hits third. And Sam Harris at first base batting cleanup. Batting fifth and playing third base, Dawson Roberts. Jaden Ziegler, the right fielder, bats sixth. Dylan Sams at second base hitting seventh. Reese Heinen, the left fielder, bats eighth. And batting ninth is the shortstop, Camden Tronson. The pitcher for Urbandale in game one is Ethan Drown. Drown, a senior, making his second start, his fifth appearance. He's 1-0 with a 6.30 ERA. 10 innings pitched, 13 hits allowed, 17 runs, 9 of them earned, 9 walks, 1 hit batter, 9 strikeouts. Opponents have hit 317 against Drown. Looks like we won't have the national anthem until game two. Urbandale already warming up for the top of the first inning. Drown, the tall, lanky right-hander, on the mound for the Jayhawks. The defense behind him has Reese Heinen in left, Drew Dykstra in center, Jaden Ziegler in right, Dawson Roberts at third, Camden Tronson at short, Dylan Sams at second, Sam Harris at first, and Gehrig Christensen is behind the plate. Ottumwa wearing the same red jerseys they wore yesterday. Big gray stripe across the front, and inside that red lettering, Ottumwa trimmed in white, white stripes above and below the gray. And the same pattern, gray with white above and below on the sleeves. White numbers on the back, white pants. Blaze Rominger leads it off for Ottumwa as we're ready to go. Right-hander Drown works from the stretch even with no one on base, and the game's first pitch swung on and missed strike one. Our first pitch at 4:59 on a hot afternoon in the capital city, or in the suburb of the capital city. Des Moines metro area here in Urbandale. And the 0-1 is a little blooper. Caught by the first baseman, Harris, for out number one. That brings up the red-hot hitting shortstop, Mitch Wood. Wood hitting .444, four home runs, 24 runs batted in. He had two homers, two doubles, and 10 RBI in the two games yesterday against Des Moines Roosevelt. Urbandale wearing navy jerseys. Red lettering on the front, white numbers front and back, white pants and white caps with blue brims. And the red and blue Urbandale U as the cap logo. First pitch to Wood, and there's a foul ball off to the right, high and out of play, strike one. 0-1 to Wood. The kick and the pitch. Low and away, one ball, one strike. Urbandale's Barton Field, very nice facility, of course, as you would expect. That pitch chopped foul over towards the Ottumwa dugout third base side and the count 1-2. A lot of foul ground between the baselines and the dugouts and behind home plate. Not quite as much as back home, I don't believe. They don't have distances on the outfield fences. It's bigger than Roosevelt's Park was yesterday. That pitch inside to Wood and the count even at 2-2. One out, nobody on, top of the first. Get you the game time weather conditions in a moment. The 2-2. On the outside corner called strike three. Wood did not like the call. And that's out number two. That brings up Jesus Jaime. Jaime hitting .566, seven doubles, two triples, two homers, and 14 RBI for the senior third baseman. Zeus steps in and the pitch. Up high, ball one. Checking my weather app as this pitch is driven into left center field. That's down for a base hit, and that's going to roll. Zeus around first on his way to second, and he will be in standing up with a two-out double. So Jaime stays red hot, and he gives Adam Greiner an RBI opportunity. 101 degrees, according to my weather app here, under sunny skies. Hottest temperatures we've seen in 4 years. Got a southwest wind at 15 miles an hour. Greiner comes in batting .286, a double and 12 RBI. Chance for number 13 here. Takes a strike on the outside corner, 0-1. That wind is blowing in from left. Now the 0-1. Downstairs, one ball, one strike. Rominger popped out, Wood struck out. Jaime doubled. Runner at second, two down for Greiner. The 1-1 from Drown in the dirt. Good backhand by the catcher Christensen, and the count goes to 2-1 on Adam. Two balls, one strike. Pitch on the way. And a ground ball to the right side. Falling down to his knees and not able to make a play after fielding it is Dylan Sams, the second baseman. Greiner safe at first. That goes in the book as an infield hit. Jaime to third, and that'll give Trey Swartz the RBI chance. First baseman, number seven, Trey Swartz. Trey hitting .357, a home run and eight driven in. He hit a three-run bomb in game one against Roosevelt yesterday afternoon. Of course, a three-run bomb here would be nice, but a base hit to drive in the first run would do. Two on, two out. Drown's pitch. Up and in, ball one. Ottumwa set the tone in both games yesterday against Roosevelt by scoring a pair in the first inning. Would love to crack the scoreboard in the opening inning here at Urbandale. The 1-0. Skied in the air, foul out of play, and the count is even at a ball and a strike. Jaime at third, Greiner at first, a double and an infield single with two down. Now the 1-1. Outside corner, strike two. One ball, two strikes. Trey will have to battle now. Drown from the stretch. He was in the stretch even with no one on base. Now two on, two out. The 1-2. On the outside corner called strike three. Trey can't believe it. But the inning is over. No runs, two hits, two left. After half an inning, Bulldogs nothing. Jayhawks coming up on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Schroeder Graphics and Signs, LLC, across the road from RJ Performance, is your go-to headquarters for all things custom designed, including vehicle wraps, printing, signs, billboards, and state-of-the-art commercial lighted signs. They also do window designs, semis, and VIN DOTs, wall designs, any size of coolers, customized bag boards, custom trailers, tumblers, race cars, go-karts, off-road vehicles, and more. Realtors, contact them for your custom yard signs, too. Visit sgsignsllc.com and like them on Facebook. Schroeder Graphics, be a brand above.
You're watching the Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network. Gotta go all the way.
Bottom of the first inning, Ottumwa had a couple of two-out hits but couldn't play to run against Urbandale, and now Max Thomason will take to the hill for the first time today. The defense behind him, Tanner Shark in left, Colt McKinnon in center, Blaze Rominger in right, Jesus Jaime at third, Mitch Wood at short, Carter Thompson at second, Trey Schwartz at first, and Adam Denniston behind the plate. Thomason, if I remember correctly, he was a Tumwa's playoff starter a year ago, now getting a start against number 10 Urbandale. Max is 2-0, 3.89 ERA. Final warm-up pitch, and the catcher, Gary Christensen, will lead it off. He'll be followed by Drew Dykstra and Dylan Kuhl. Christensen, a left-handed batter. Hitting .478, seven doubles and 14 runs batted in. That's a lot of RBI from the leadoff spot. First pitch from Max, slings it in there, but a little bit wide, 1-0. The 1-0 pitch, downstairs 2-0. Two balls, no strikes. Thomason's next offering. That's in there for a strike, 2-1. Max wanting to work quickly here. 2-1 offering to Christensen. Fly ball to left. Going back is Shark over towards the line. Makes the catch for out number one. That brings up the center fielder, Drew Dykstra.
Batting second, the center fielder, number 16, Drew Dykstra.
I do find it interesting that the top two hitters in the Urbandale order both share names with major leaguers. Gehrig Christensen, his first name is, of course, the same as the great Yankee Lou Gehrig. Drew Dykstra shares a last name with longtime Mets and Phillies center fielder Lenny Dykstra. And Drew Dykstra hits a fly ball to center, going back McKinnon, but he's there. Makes the catch, two down. So two quick outs for Thomason. Dykstra had come into that at-bat hitting .294. And now the batter is the designated hitter, Dylan Kuhl, K-U-E-H-L, hitting .388, four home runs and 26 RBI. So his numbers very similar to Mitch Woods. Kuhl, a left-handed hitter. Thomason's given up a couple of fly balls, but no damage so far, and that pitch sails in high for ball one. Two out, nobody on. Bottom of the first, the 1-0. I guess a little inside, 2-0. Thomason fell behind Christensen 2-0, but he eventually got him to fly out. Let's see if he can battle back here against Kuhl, the 2-0. Way outside, 3-0. First baseman Sam Harris on deck. Three balls, no strikes. The pitch. Took something off, got it over for a strike, 3-1. The 3-1. Ground ball to the left, backhanded by Mitch Wood. The shortstop's throw is in time to retire the side as Thomason sets down Urbandale in order. We've played an inning. Bulldogs nothing, Jayhawks nothing on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Hi everyone, this is Karina Drummond with Reflection Studio in Ottumwa. We are a full-service salon offering hair, nail, brow, lash, facial, and waxing services. We also handle weddings, proms, and other large events with multiple person makeover sessions, so contact us early to get booked for your next event. We thank all of our loyal customers for your patronage and invite all newcomers to join our salon family. And remember, looking good doesn't happen by chance, it happens by appointment with Reflection Studio in Ottumwa. Like Reflection Studio on Facebook and visit ReflectionStudio.com. That's Reflections with a Z.
You're watching the Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
You be scared of John, watch me leap though.
Top of the second inning, Bulldog Baseball brought to you by Community First Credit Union with 17 locations to serve you. By Dr. Dwayne Petrito at Petrito Orthodontics in Ottumwa and Oskaloosa, where they want to give you a smile that lasts a lifetime. Call today for an appointment. And by Reflection Studio next to New Care Pharmacy in downtown Ottumwa. Looking good doesn't happen by chance, it happens by appointment with Reflection Studio in Ottumwa. No score, Bulldogs and Jayhawks, top of the second inning. Carter Thompson will lead it off for OHS, followed by Max Thomason and Tanner Shark. Carter hitting 344, 8 runs batted in. Ethan Drown on the mound, and his pitch is in the dirt for ball one to Thompson. The right-hander is 1-0, downstairs again 2-0. Bulldogs got a lot of production yesterday from the bottom half of the order against Roosevelt. There's a strike 2-1. Now, obviously, they got great production from Mitch Wood, Jesus Jaime, Griner Swartz, but there are a lot of innings. You look back at my scorebook here, a lot of runs scored by that bottom half. Another pitch called a strike on the outside corner, and by every reaction I'm seeing to those pitches, that corner is quite generous in the early going. 2-2 to Thompson. Brown delivers, and a one hopper out to the third baseman, fielded by Roberts, throw across in time for out number one. That brings up Max Thomason. Limited at bats this season. Ottumwa's lineup is so good, especially the way Carter Thompson has played, it's hard to find Max time at second base. But when he has hit, he's 8-for-14, 5.71, a triple and 8 runs batted in. Takes a pitch a little bit low and away for ball one. One out, nobody on, top second, no score. And the pitch. Fouled straight back to the screen, and we're even at a ball and a strike. Bright sunshine and 101 degrees, but that hasn't stopped a good contingent of Ottumwa fans from coming up. It hasn't stopped some Urbandale fans from coming out as well. Ooh, that pitch a little bit upstairs and inside to Thomason, 2-1. Drowns 2-1 to Max, inside 3-1. Hitters count for Thomason here, trying to help his own cause. Tanner Shark on deck. The 3-1. Swing and a miss, 3-2. And Thomason was trying to wait and see if that pitch would be exactly what he wanted, but waited a little too long to make up his mind. 3 balls, 2 strikes. Now the payoff. Outside ball 4. One out walk gives Ottumwa a base runner here in the second inning. Will we get a courtesy runner? I believe we will. Coach Yeager calling for time.
Batting 8, the left fielder, number 2, Tanner Shark.
And it will be Lucas Barnes to run for Thomason. So Barnes at first, Shark at the plate.
First base with Bulldogs, number 22, Lucas Barnes.
Tanner hitting 171. Couple of doubles, a home run, and nine driven in. Left-handed batter. Game two winning pitcher yesterday against Roosevelt. That pitch well high for ball one to Shark. Left-handed batting, left fielder digs back in. Now the 1-0. That's in their first strike, 1-1. Heard one of the Urbandale fans call out to Ethan Drown, say you're just fine, number two. Because Drown wears number two, obviously. But Tanner Shark at the plate, he also wears number two. So encouragement for both hitter and pitcher. That pitch, check swing and a foul off to the left over the head of Colt McKinnon in the on-deck circle. Shark down in the count 1-2. That was going to be ball two. It was up too high, but Shark not able to check his swing enough. Barnes, a runner at first with one down, top second, no score. The pitch, high and away, 2-2. Drown comes set, the 2-2 pitch, high and away, 3-2. And this is how the bottom half of the Ottumwa order has been able to be productive, even though the batting averages in some cases aren't all that good. They take pitches, they draw walks, they get on base. The 3-2. Down and in, ball four. Back-to-back walks by Thomason and Shark. So Barnes, the courtesy runner at second, Shark at first, and here's McKinnon with one down. Colton has that average all the way up to 226. With nine runs batted in, I say all the way up. He was in the 170s yesterday. But then he was 4-for-8 in the doubleheader at Roosevelt. Two on, one out. First pitch. Strike at the knees, 0-1. If you look at it from the Urbandale perspective, Ethan Drown had to get ahead in the count there after walking two batters in a row. The 0-1, bunt shown, bunted foul at the plate, and it's 0-2. The third baseman, Roberts, was playing back. If McKinnon could have gotten that ball down the third baseline fair, we probably would have had bases loaded. Instead, it's 0-2 to the Bulldogs center fielder. No score, Ottumwa trying to put together a rally, 2-on-1 out. The 0-2, in the dirt, bounces a little bit up the first baseline, but Ottumwa's runners hold as Christensen, the catcher, runs it down. 1-2 to McKinnon. Drown again from the stretch, a couple looks at second. The pitch, chop foul at the plate, and McKinnon stays alive at 1-2. Bulldogs are making Ethan Drown work hard in this 100-degree heat. That's 21 pitches in this inning already, and there's only one down. Now another 1-2. Ground ball right side, fielded and bobbled by the second baseman. That's into shallow right center. Racing home is Barnes, and he will beat the throw. Ottumwa takes a 1-0 lead. Dylan Sams maybe thinking about the throw to second before he fielded the ball cleanly. It got past him. And the speed of Barnes brought him around to score. Shark stayed at second. McKinnon on the error, and we're back to the top of the order, Blaze Rominger, who popped out to start the game. Ottumwa grabs the early lead. First and second, one out. And the pitch. Fouled back over the screen, out of play, 0-1. Never did get to tell you what Blaze's numbers were coming in. A 4-10 hitter before his first at-bat with 12 RBI. Now at 0-1 here, first and second, one out, you got Mitch Wood and Jesus Jaime to follow. This might be a time to lay down a bunt. And the third baseman, Roberts, about even with the bag, shows bunt, but he popped it foul back to the screen, 0-2. You could see the strategy there for Coach Yeager. Let your 400 hitting leadoff man swing away on the first pitch and then maybe try to drop down a bunt when they're not thinking you will, but Ottumwa couldn't get the bunt down. 0-2 to Blaze. Two on, one out, one in. And the pitch grounded up the middle slowly, fielded by the shortstop Tronson. They'll get the force at second, but that's all. As Tronson took it to the bag himself, Rominger reaches on the fielder's choice. McKinnon out, six unassisted, and it's runners at the corners, two down for Mitch Wood, who was called out on strikes his first time up. That out makes the run scored by Barnes unearned, as if they hadn't committed the error, the inning would have been over before he could have scored. But now Mitch Wood trying to make it a crooked number, runners on the corners, two down. The pitch. Ground ball sharply past the third baseman into left field, base hit. Scoring is Tanner Shark. Stopping at second is Rominger. It's 2-0 Bulldogs on the two-out RBI single by Mitch Wood. Give him 25 on the season. And there's 2-on, 2-out for Jesus Jaime, who doubled his first time up. Bulldogs take advantage of the Urbandale mistake. Let's see if they can keep adding to it. The pitch. Breaking ball, grounded to third, down to a knee to field it is Roberts. The throw across is high, and it's all the way to the barrier. Rominger races home. Wood will stop at third. And it's 3-0. Second error of the inning committed by the Jayhawks, and it costs them another run. 3-0 at Ottumwa. Runners on the corners, two down. And the batter, Adam Greiner, who had an infield hit his first time up. And before Greiner bats, time is called as we'll get a visit to the mound here. Probably just trying to make sure that Ethan Drown is settled down, because you could really make a case that this inning is not his fault. A couple of errors in the frame have opened the floodgates for 3 Ottumwa runs. The mound visit over. Mitch Wood at third, Jesus Jaime at first. Two down, 3 runs home. Ottumwa only has the one hit, the single by Wood in the inning. But a couple of walks have scored, and also 2 errors committed in the frame. Now Drown's pitch to Greiner. There's a strike, 0-1. Adam, the eighth man to bat in the inning. Oh, and one to Greiner. Jaime gets a short lead over at first. The pitch. Liner into right. That is caught on a dive by Jalen Ziegler to retire the side, and that robs Greiner of an RBI hit. But Ottumwa gets 3 runs on 1 hit. There were 2 errors and 2 left on base. We go to the bottom of the second inning. Ottumwa 3, Urbandale nothing on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Hello, this is Lisa Bittner, Clinic Manager with Mercy One Ottumwa Family and Internal Medicine. We specialize in pediatrics to geriatrics, internal medicine, and family practice, basically from babies to grandparents. We are here for you. We want to be your primary care provider. Call us at 641-683-0800 to schedule an appointment. Mercy One Ottumwa Family and Internal Medicine Clinic, 522 North Hancock Street in Ottumwa. Your best life, our one purpose. Visit mercyone.org.
You're watching the Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network. I ain't choose the gang, gang drove me.
Bottom of the second inning, Bulldog Baseball. Brought to you by Andrew Schroeder with Schroeder Graphics and Sign LLC. Visit sgsignllc.com and like Schroeder Graphics LLC, Schroeder Graphics and Sign LLC on Facebook. Schroeder Graphics, be a brand above. By Mark and the team at Champion Bowl in Ottumwa, stop out and see the new and improved look, and they aren't done yet. More upgrades are on the way to Champion Bowl, where bowling is fun. And by Citizens Mutual in Bloomfield, your premium broadband provider expanding into Wapello County. Please go to findmyfiber.mycmtech.com to express interest in fiber internet at your home. 3-0 Ottumwa as Urbandale bats in the bottom of the second. First pitch is skied to shallow left. Coming in is Shark. Still coming in. And Tanner unable to make the catch. Throw comes to second, not in time. And the wind played havoc with that one, allowing Sam Harris, the first baseman, to get into second on what should be an error on Ottumwa, and it is. So an error puts a runner at second with nobody out, and here's the third baseman, Dawson Roberts, first pitch. Up and in, ball one. Roberts hitting .261. He's hit a home run. He's driven in 12. Max Thomason trying to pitch around that error that starts this bottom of the second inning. That pitch in there for a strike, and it's 1-1. Thomason pitched a 1-2-3 first inning. Now the 1-1 to Ziegler, to Roberts, pardon me, is a strike, 1-2. Jalen Ziegler is on deck. Strikeout would be big here for Max. The 1-2. In the dirt, knocked down by Christensen, by Denniston, but it rolled all the way or halfway back to the mound. And the wild pitch allows Harris to go to third. Kind of overthrew that breaking ball. And the count is 2-2 now with a runner at third and nobody out. Two balls, two strikes. Thomason's pitch. Popped it up, right side foul. It'll get out of play. And we stay at 2-2. Still 2-2 to Dawson Roberts. Thomason's pitch. Up and away, 3-2. Three balls, two strikes. Thomason's pitch. Inside, ball four. Well, this has been a frustrating start to the inning for Ottumwa. You've got a shallow fly to left, drop for an error. And then you have a situation where you're way ahead of a hitter and ended up walking him. So Jalen Ziegler, the right fielder, hitting .348 with 9 runs batted in. Some infield will trade a double play for a run right here. First pitch. In the dirt, rolls up the third baseline. That's going to be far enough to allow Roberts to get to second. It's now 1-0 count and second and third, nobody out. One ball, no strikes. The next pitch. Check swing, apparently inside, 2-0. Two balls, no strikes. The pitch. Downstairs, 3-0. Dylan Sams on deck. Thomason worked himself into a jam here. The pitch. Outside corner strike, 3-1. Three balls, one strike, second and third, nobody out. The pitch fouled off to the left, 3-2. Well, now Thomason with an opportunity to get a strikeout that, again, would be big for him in this situation. Ottumwa leading 3-0, but Urbandale threatening. Second and third, nobody out, bottom second. The pitch. Liner foul off to the left into the Ottumwa bullpen. And we'll do it again at 3-2. Thomason gets the sign from Denniston. The 3-2. I guess a little bit high. Ball four. They're loaded. And the batter, Dylan Sams. Sams, a senior, hitting 265. He is driven in six. He does not have an extra base hit yet this year. And again, the middle infield to play for a double play here. They give up a run to turn two. Corner infielders have come in. Ground ball to third or first, you're coming home for that force and maybe a double play home to first. The pitch. Ground ball back to the mound. Thomason will throw home. They get the force there. No relay to first. Max thought about throwing to second and then realized he could get the force at home. There's out number one. Harris retired 1-2. Nice stab of that ball on the mound by Max. Roberts to third, Ziegler to second, Sam safe at first on the fielder's choice, and the batter, it's a left fielder, Reese Heinen. Heinen, a senior, batting 091 with four runs batted in. The pitch, swing and a miss, blew it right by him, 0-1. Heinen is 4-for-44. He has walked 8 times, but he struck out 21 times. For Max, this has got to be a guy you set down on strikes. That pitch, I guess, inside, 1-1. A Jayhawk at every base, but now one out. Ottumwa was still leading 3-0. Ace is wild on the scoreboard, the 1-1. Chop foul at the plate, 1-2. On deck is a shortstop, Camden Tronson. One ball, two strikes. And Max will step off the rubber. Some of the kids here at the ball game getting the frozen treats from the concession stand. See the drumstick and the frozen popsicle? Sounds good, but we'll keep on going here. The 1-2 on the outside corner called strike three. Big strikeout, big second out for Thomason. And now with bases loaded, two out, the inning is up to the shortstop, Camden Tronson. The number 9 hitter, another left-handed hitter. Seems like Urbandale's got a bunch of those. Tronson hitting 205 with 5 RBI. An error, a couple of walks, loading the bases with nobody out, but then a ground ball to the mound and a strikeout. And there's a ground ball to Thompson at second, and he bobbles it, picks it up. No, he won't have a play. And Ottumwa gives away a run on an error. It's 3-1. Thomason would have been out of the inning. Instead, Roberts will score. Ziegler to third, Sams to second. No RBI on the play. It's an unearned run. And we're back to the top of the order. Garrett Christensen, who flew out to left his first time up. Had a chance to retire the 205 hitter. Now you got to face a kid hitting 478 coming in. Bases loaded, two down. Ottumwa's lead cut to 3-1. Righty to lefty, Thomason to Christensen. Bit inside, ball one. One and oh to the Urbandale catcher. Pitch on the way. Strike on the inside corner, 1-1. Urbandale threatening to wipe away the Ottumwa lead, which had been 3-0 after the top of this second inning. Time called at the plate. One ball, one strike. That pitch misses in the count 2-1. Jayhawk at every base. The 2-1. Ground ball foul right side, 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Thomason should have been out of this jam with no runs scoring. Now the 2-2. Swing and a miss, strike three and a breaking ball, and the inning is over. Great pitch, great execution by Thomason, and the damage is minimal. One run, no hits, two errors, three left. After two, Bulldogs 3, Jayhawks 1 on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
We all have a picture of the life we want to live, a desire to connect the work we do with the purpose. There is a way to get there, but the price of admission is money and the drive to succeed. Success takes skill. Skill takes training. Training takes work. If you're ready to live, learn, train, and connect, Job Corps is ready for you. Careers begin here.
You're watching the Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Top of the third inning. Lots of miscues by both teams in the second inning, but Ottumwa took better advantage, and they lead here at Urbandale 3-1. For the Bulldogs, it'll be Swartz, Thompson, and Thomason due up against Ethan Drown, the right-hander. Swartz called out on strikes his first time up. Right-hander to right-hander, Drown's pitch. Strike at the knees, 0-1. No balls and a strike to the Bulldog first baseman. The next offering in the dirt. Count evens at a ball and a strike. Well, we were saying last inning that Ottumwa was getting production from the bottom of the order. As that pitch bounces in there, 2-1. And in the second inning, both Thomason and Shark walked, and those walks both came home to score in that three-run frame. That pitch swung on and missed by Trey, and the count is even at 2-2. It is a hot one here in Urbandale and everywhere in Iowa. The 2-2. Low and away, 3-2. And Drown is throwing a lot of pitches. He threw 28 in that three-run second inning. He has already thrown 50 in the game in this heat. Now the 3-2. Downstairs, ball four. Swartz draws a leadoff walk. Third free pass issued by Ethan Drown. And that'll bring up Carter Thompson, who grounded to third his first time up.
Now batting the second baseman, Carter Thompson.
See what Thompson is asked to do here. He swings away at the first pitch and fouls it back. Out of play, 0-1. Fouled it back towards the area of the parking lot by the front gate here where we unloaded our equipment but wisely did not park there. Oh and one to Thompson. See if a bunt is in the cards now. He shows bunt and it came at his head but he got it down. Drown picked it up, dropped it, picked it up again. Still had time to throw to first for the out. Thompson was slow getting out of the box. Not really his fault. That pitch came up at his head. He still got the bunt down back towards the mound, but he was stumbling backwards when it came in. So he kind of spun the wheels getting out of the box. If he'd been able to get going a little faster, he might have beaten the rap because Drown fumbled the ball the first time, but not Carter's fault. He still gets the sacrifice as Swartz goes to second. Score at 1-3. And the batter, Max Thomason, who walked his first time up. First pitch here, fouled back to the screen, strike one. Mentioned that Barton Field is one of the nicer facilities in the state. And they have a brick backstop of the fence atop of it, the brick just a few feet high. As that pitch is skied to center, but it's right in the tracks of Dykstra. He goes back and makes the catch, two down, as Schwartz will stay at second. And the batter, Tanner Shark, who walked and scored in the second inning. But some of these bricks are memorial bricks. Some of them honor some great fans that Urbandale has had. Some of them honor great players that they've had over the years. There's one for Urbandale Little League, which has had a great history in its own right. That pitch up high to Shark, 1-0. And there's a brick right in front of me, and it's a player we remember, Carter Tronson. I assume he's Camden Tronson's older brother. As the pitch to Shark is downstairs, 2-0. Runner at second, two down. Top third at Ottumwa, leading 3-1. But what makes me smile at the Carter Tronson was, it says Carter Tronson, the years he played, 15-18, and then never bunt. Carter didn't like laying one down, apparently. The 2-0 to Shark, way high and outside, 3-0. And Tanner would gladly draw a walk and keep the line moving with Colton McKinnon on deck. Schwartz walked to lead off the inning. Thompson bunted him to second. Thomason flew out to center. Now the 3-0 to Shark. In the dirt, ball four. The first pitch that Ethan Drown throws to Colton McKinnon will be his 60th of the game. It'll come with runners in first, at first and second, two down. Ottumwa leading 3-1, and again, the bottom of the order trying to add to it. The pitch. Liner into right center. That's down for a base hit. Schwartz around third. They're sending him home. Dykstra up with it. The throw is cut off. They will throw to third, or they fake a throw to third, but in safely is Shark. It's an RBI single for McKinnon, and Ottumwa leads it 4-1. Great two-out hitting for Colton McKinnon to pick up the RBI and get that run back that Urbandale scored in the bottom of the second. And again, Ottumwa makes Urbandale pay, this time for the walk to Schwartz. And now Shark at third, he walked. Drown has walked four in this game. Three of them have come in to score, and another one's 90 feet away. Blaze can get on. He is 0 for 2. The pitch. A little bit inside, ball one. 4-1 Ottumwa on the road at number 10 Urbandale. Bulldogs trying to prove they belong in the top 10. The 1-0. Upstairs, 2-0. And I love Ottumwa's approach at the plate. We're not anxious. We're not trying too hard. We're willing to take pitches. We're not chasing stuff. The 2-0. Inside, 3-0. And if you walk Rominger, you load the bases with Mitch Wood. Blaze probably has the take sign here. Cannot see the Urbandale bullpen from here. As the 3-0 is a strike at the knees, 3-1. Not only was Rominger taking all the way, you don't want to swing at that pitch anyway. That is a pitcher's pitch, right on the black, right at the knees. Let that one go. Now the 3-1. High ball four. Third walk of the inning, fifth of the game, and they're loaded for Mitch Wood, who's 1-for-2 with an RBI single. We'll get a visit to the mound here. And that's going to be all for Ethan Drown. Urbandale going to the pen in the third inning with Ottumwa already leading by three. We'll take 30 seconds. Come back and tell you about the new pitcher after this on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
It's time to choose the credit union with a new perspective. At Meridian Credit Union, we don't just see member profiles. We see people. People with goals. People who want to save more. People that we can help. That's why we offer financial services convenient to you. Great loan rates, online banking with bill pay, mobile banking, and credit cards. Join the many satisfied Meridian members today. See how our perspective can help you.
Meridian Credit Union, where it feels like home.
You're watching the Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
The new Urbandale pitcher is right-handed senior Colin Perez, making his sixth appearance. He's made one start. He's 2-0 with a 1.26 ERA, 16 and two-thirds innings pitched, 17 hits allowed, 10 runs, only 3 earned. He has walked 10, and he's hit a batter. He struck out 18, opponents hitting 262 against him. So I guess the question is, with the stats, is how deceiving is that 1.26 ERA? Because, again, he's only allowed 3 earned runs, but 10 runs in total. And Urbandale has shown, at least in this game, that they're a little shaky defensively. 2 errors led to 3 Ottumwa runs in the second inning. Now, he's a big strikeout guy, 18 Ks and 16 and two-thirds. He's also walked 10. Mitch Wood at the plate. And Mitch on the season, 16 walks and only 2 strikeouts. So if Perez is not in the zone, I don't expect Mitch to chase. There's a reason. There's a lot of reasons he's going to Iowa to play baseball. Right here, he's got a chance to break it open for Ottumwa. Bases loaded, 2 down. Bulldogs already ahead, 4-1. The pitch. In the dirt, ball 1. Good stop by the catcher, Christensen. Ethan Drown through 2 2/3 innings, charged with 4 runs, only 1 earned, but he's responsible for all 3 runners on base. The 1-0. Outside, 2-0 with no place to put him. Two balls, no strikes. Wood with a hitter's count. The pitch. Swing and a miss, 2-1. Big cut, no contact. Two and one to Mitch. Perez from the windup. Way outside, 3-1. No margin of error remaining for Colin Perez, the reliever. Ball 4 would walk in a run and bring Jesus Jaime to the plate. Boy, Zeus just itching for a chance here. Wood hoping for something he can drive. Now the 3-1. Swing and a foul back, 3-2. Love it when someone walks right in front of me as a pitch is coming in. We've gone as far as we can go. 3 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs, bases loaded. Ball 4 means a run. Strike 3 ends the inning. A base hit would likely score multiple runs. Runners will be on the move as well. There they go, the 3-2. Fly ball pretty deep to left. Going back, Heinen, drifting with it, has room, makes the catch shy of the wall to retire the side. Boy, Mitch Wood just missed a grand slam. Ottumwa does get a run on a hit. They leave 3. We go to the bottom of the third. Bulldogs up 4-1 on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Hi, this is Vince Tyson, General Manager with Citizens Mutual in Bloomfield, the area's premier broadband provider. Wapello County, we have heard your screams of frustration. You need reliable internet, and we are proud to expand high-speed fiber internet into Wapello County. Express your interest today by going to findmyfiber.mycmtech.com. Again, that's findmyfiber.mycmtech.com. We look forward to hearing from you and bringing you the very best internet service at Citizens Mutual, coming soon to Wapello County.
You're watching the Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network. I do it for the love.
Bottom of the third inning. Bulldog Baseball brought to you by Mike and the team at Mike's Pizza, Ottumwa's favorite place to eat. By Josh, Brenda, and the team at Meridian Credit Union, where it feels like home. And by Ottumwa Job Corps Center, providing the skills you need to succeed in today's workforce at no cost to you. Visit OttumwaJobCorps.gov. 2-3-4 due up for Urbandale here. Drew Dykstra, Dylan Cool, Sam Harris. Ottumwa leading 4-1. Max Thomason winds and delivers righty to lefty. Bunt shown, pitch taken for a strike, 0-1. Dykstra flew out to center his first time up. Max winds in the 0-1. In there for a strike, 0-2. Thomason maybe learning something from the struggles of his starting counterpart, Ethan Drown, who departed after 2 2/3 innings, having walked 5. The 0-2. Popped it up. Coming in is Jesus Jaime, left side, makes the catch on the grass for out number 1. That'll bring up the DH, Dylan Cool, grounded to short his first time up. Powerful left-handed batter, four home runs on the year, stands in for the second time. The wind and the pitch. Breaking ball in there for a strike, 0-1. Thomason's next offering. Another breaking ball, that one on the outside corner, 0-2. One out, nobody on, bottom three. Getting a little ahead of myself there. Ottumwa leading 4-1. When we have the lead, the innings never go fast enough. The pitch, in the dirt, couldn't get him to chase, 1-2. As soon as Ottumwa put a three spot on the board in the second inning, my mind was saying, let's just skip to the seventh. Long way to go against the number 10 team in the state as Ottumwa looks for its 10th win in a row. The 1-2. Just off the plate outside, 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Pitch on the way. There's a liner to center. McKinnon is right there to make the catch for out number two. Thomason's done a pretty good job this game of letting his defense do the work. Two out, nobody on. The batter, Sam Harris, who reached on an error in the second inning. He was eventually thrown out at home on a force play. Urbandale would go on to get a run in that second inning, but they left him loaded. Ottumwa got a run in the third inning, but left him loaded. First pitch here is grounded to the right side and in the right center for a base hit. A two-out single for Sam Harris. That's the first hit of the game for Urbandale. And that'll let Dawson Roberts bat here in the third. He walked his first time up. Righty-righty matchup here. That kind of feels rare with this Urbandale lineup. They send a lot of left-handed hitters to the plate. Thomason, a couple of nods in the pitch, and there's a fly ball to right, going back. Rominger still going back, reaches up, makes the catch. That ball nearly fooled him. A few balls hit hard in the inning, but Urbandale does not score. No runs, one hit, one left. We've played three here at Barton Field. Ottumwa leading the Jayhawks 4-1 on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Seasons change. Our priorities change. Your financial needs change. But there's one thing that remains consistent. Our dedication to making your financial life easier. Together. So let's get to know each other. Because together is better.
You're watching the Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
I did not come to play, I came to dominate. Dominate.
For the fourth inning, Ottumwa 4, Urbandale 1, as the Bulldogs get ready to bat with Jesus Jaime, Adam Griner, and Trey Swartz against right-handed reliever Colin Perez, who got the Jayhawks out of a bases-loaded jam, came on to face Mitch Wood, bases-loaded two out in the third, and Wood flew out to deep left field. That wind is blowing in out of the southwest, and the way this field's oriented, that's kind of blowing in from left center, and that wind may have kept the ball in the park. Jesus Jaime, 1-for-2. He's doubled. He's reached on an error. And the pitch. Breaking ball skied off to the right, fouling out of play, 0-1. Ottumwa out hitting Urbandale 4-1 and outscoring them 4-1. There's a pop foul to the right out of play, 0-2. Each team with two errors. Those two Urbandale errors led to three Ottumwa runs. The two Ottumwa errors only led to one Urbandale run. That was all in the second inning. The 0-2. Chase to pitch in the dirt, strike three, picked up by Christensen, and the throw down to first in time to finish the put out for out number one. That brings up Adam Greiner, who feels like he should be 2-for-2. He singled in the first inning and then a line drive to right that should have been an RBI single, but he was robbed on a diving catch by Jalen Ziegler. Batting with one out, nobody on here in the fourth. And a breaking ball strike, 0-1. Feels like Perez has thrown nothing but off-speed pitches here in the top of the fourth. The 0-1. There's a fastball, and it's skied to shallow right center, backing up the second baseman. And Sams will make the catch for out number two. Two out, nobody on for Trey Swartz. He has struck out, he has walked. 0-1. The kick and the pitch. Up high, ball one. Next offering is outside to Trey, and he's worked himself ahead 2-0. Working quickly, Perez's 2-0 is on the outside corner, two balls and a strike. The next offering to Swartz. Fly ball to center. It's shallow. Racing in is Dykstra. He'll get to the spot, make the catch. And Ottumwa goes down in order for the first time. We go to the bottom of the fourth inning. Ottumwa 4, Urbandale 1 on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Hi, I'm Dr. Dwayne Petrito, your orthodontist in Ottumwa and Oskaloosa. Many of our patients are playing in this game, and we want you to know we are happy to see you representing your school and playing hard. If you haven't been in to see us yet, please call our office for an appointment. Your first appointment is always free. From start to finish, we are here for you every step of the way. We specialize in giving you a great smile and bite. We look forward to seeing you soon. Our team is cheering for you in today's game.
Watching the Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Bottom of the fourth inning, Bulldog Baseball this season, brought to you by Slayton Polaris, your home for the best deals on Polaris Rangers and ATVs. Call or stop in and see them today, 8 miles south and west of Pulaski. By Mercy One Ottumwa Family and Internal Medicine Clinic, 522 North Hancock Street in Ottumwa, your best life, our one purpose, visit mercyone.org. And by Lisco, Southeast Iowa's leader in fiber optic telecommunications, Lisco of Fairfield. Still 4-1 Ottumwa as Urbandale bats here in the bottom of the fourth inning. 6, 7, and 8 due up in their order. Ziegler, Sams, and Heinen. Jalen Ziegler walked his first time up. The line by Max Thomason in the pitch. Fly ball, really a pop-up. Right side of the infield. Thompson is called off by Mitch Wood, who ran right in front of him to make the catch for out number one. Wood came way over from his shortstop spot. Thomason ended up, looked like Wood caught it, and then maybe handed it to Thomason because it was Thomason who threw it over to Jaime. Either way, it's out number one, although it looked kind of awkward. Dylan Sams, the batter. He bounced into a fielder's choice his first time up. First pitch, and the dirt ball one. A 1-0, up high, 2-0. Thomason's 2-0 pitch, grounded foul towards the Ottumwa dugout, 2-1. 2-1 in there for a strike, and we're even to Sam's at 2-2. Now the wind and the 2-2 pitch. Fly ball to center. Drifting back with it is McKinnon. He's there to make the catch. Two down. And that brings up the left fielder, Reese Heinen, who was called out on strikes his first time up. That was a big out in that second inning. Came with the bases loaded and one down. Thomason really should have gotten out of that jam with no run scoring. The run scored on a ground ball that was booted for an error. First pitch here. Breaking ball just off the plate outside, 1-0. The umpire, I thought he was going to stand up and call a strike, but he did not. Now the 1-0. Strike at the letters, 1-1. One ball, one strike, two out, nobody on. Bottom of the fourth, Ottumwa leading 4-1. The pitch, down and away, 2-1 to Heinen. The 2-1 pitch, swing and a miss, blew it right by him, 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. The pitch, way outside, 3-2. Number nine hitter Camden Tronson on deck. Tronson only a 205 hitter. You'd much rather get Heinen here and have the number nine hitter leading off the fifth. The 3-2. Swing and a miss, strike three, and it's a 1-2-3 frame for Max Thomason. We go to the fifth inning, Ottumwa 4, Urbandale 1 on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Wondering what to have for lunch or supper? Stop in and see Mike and his team at Mike's Pizza and Steakhouse. Whether you want amazing Greek food, pasta, salads, sandwiches, fish, chicken, steak, or the best pizza in town, they have what you want. They are always open for carryout, and their full menu is available at mikespizzasteakhouse.com. Thank you, Southern Iowa, for making Mike's Pizza and Steakhouse your favorite restaurant and your favorite pizza place. Proud to support the Ottumwa Bulldogs. Opa!
You're watching the Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
You be scared of Joan, watch me lead, though.
Ottumwa maintains its 4-1 lead. Bulldogs have Carter Thompson, Max Thomason, and Tanner Shark due up. Right-hander Colin Perez still in the game for Urbandale. Perez has retired all four batters he's faced. Ottumwa, four runs, four hits, two errors. Urbandale, one run, one hit, two errors. Perez will work from the windup here and the pitch. Strike at the knees, 0-1 to Carter, who was grounded out and laid down a sacrifice bunt. The 0-1 on the way. Breaking ball downstairs, one ball, one strike. Perez works very quickly, we appreciate that. That pitch is a soft liner into left field for a base hit. So Carter Thompson has the fifth hit of game one for OHS. And that'll bring up Max Thomason, who has walked and flied to center. This would seem like a time when Ottumwa would lay down a bunt. Let's see if that's the plan or if Coach Yeager wants to cross it up and have Max swing away. Shows bunt early. And gets a good bunt down third base side, fielded by Roberts. Throw to first in time by an eyelash for out number one. That's a 5-3 on the sacrifice. Thomason does his job. Thompson to second, and the batter Tanner Shark, who's walked twice. Runner at second, one down. Ottumwa leading 4-1. Would love to bring Thompson around to score and get some insurance here as we moved into the latter half of game one. First pitch, way high, ball one. One ball, no strikes to the Bulldog left fielder. The next offering from Perez. Strike at the knees, 1-1. This kid throws hard. And that velocity actually keeps that ball in the strike zone. When he released that pitch, I thought it was going into the dirt, but put enough speed and backspin on it, and it'll stay on that same plane. Now the 1-1. Inside, 2-1. In the hit by Thompson, the first base runner Perez has allowed since coming on in relief. 2-1 to Shark. Popped it up near second. It will be the shortstop Tronson to make the play, and there's two down, and it's up to Colton McKinnon, who's 1-for-2 with an RBI single. Now batting the center fielder, Colton McKinnon. Perez came into this outing 10 walks and 18 strikeouts. We really haven't seen him show any signs of being a kid who walks somebody, although he did fall behind Mitch Wood when he got out of the third inning. That pitch in there. Did the umpire look like he started to call a strike and then didn't? So the scoreboard says 0-1, and I was about to say he called it a strike, but then that it looked like he stopped, so I think maybe it's 1-0. That pitch missed up high. Scoreboard has 1-1, but I'm going with 2-0 here. Yep, it's 2-0. The umpire started to call the first pitch a strike and stopped. So a hitter's count for McKinnon, 2-0. And this pitch, high 3-0. Top of the order, Blaze Rominger on deck. Well, every time you get down here to the number 9 spot, you start thinking, well, if McKinnon can get on, Rominger can get on, then Wood and Jaime with guys on base is what you love to see. The 2-1. That's a strike. Pardon me, that was a 3-0. Now it's 3-1. Okay, if Perez throws a strike here, the fans are going to be confused and upset on the Urbandale side because the scoreboard says 2-2. But the umpire did signal, and now they're changing it, 3-1. Swing and a miss, and now it's 3-2. All right, three balls, two strikes. Everything's sorted out. Let's see if Colton can either get on base or get a base hit. The 3-2. Swing and a miss, strike three. And Perez comes all the way back to get him, inning over. One hit, one left. We go to the bottom of the fifth. Bulldogs up 4-1 on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
We know now more than ever how important high-speed fiber internet is to our customers, ranging from at-home work, at-home schooling, and all of your online gaming and streaming requests. We have you covered, but don't wait. Our springtime queue is filling up fast, and I want to help you get your name on that list. Call me, Samantha, your local Lisco sales rep at 641-209-5400. That's 209-5400, or visit our website at www.lisco.com.
Watching the Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network. I ain't choose the gang, gang chose me.
Bottom of the fifth inning. Ottumwa still leading Urbandale 4-1. Jayhawks have 9-1-2 due up in their order. Camden Tronson, Garrett Christensen, Drew Dykstra. Leading off the bottom of the fifth, the Jayhawks, the shortstop, Camden Tronson. Only 57 pitches through four innings for Max Thomason, so he has not been overtaxed to this point. Tronson stands in, reached on an error, his first time up, lays down a bunt, or tried to, but missed it. And the count 0-1. A deep breath from Max in the 0-1. Ground ball right side, Swartz has it clean, and he'll step on the bag for out number one. Sharply hit, but there's one away. Ottumwa had two errors in that second inning, and it cost them a run. But otherwise, the Bulldog defense has been very solid. Gary Christensen has flied to left and has struck out. That strikeout came with the bases loaded and two down in the second inning. And it got Thomason out of the jam with only minimal damage. One out, nobody on here in the fifth, and the pitch, breaking ball inside, 1-0. Some clouds have rolled in enough to obscure some of the sunshine, and that is a relief to everybody here out in this 100-degree heat. That pitch way outside, and it's 2-0 to Christensen. We started at 101 degrees at 4:59. Now we're a little past 6 o'clock. The 2-0. Letter high strike, 2-1. It's cooled off. It's only 99 degrees. But again, if that sun stays behind the clouds, it doesn't feel so bad. That pitch lined into center right over Thomason's head for a one-out single. And we will have a courtesy runner for the catcher. Little surprise, if your catcher hits leadoff, usually he runs well enough you don't bother with a courtesy. Caleb German will be the courtesy runner. One on, one out for Drew Dykstra, who's flied to center and popped to third. German, the runner at first, 2-for-2 in stolen base tries, and a throw to first will chase him back. Unlike our home diamond, and kind of unlike yesterday at Roosevelt, the sun is not a factor for a first baseman holding a runner on, as the sun will actually set behind the right field corner here at Barton Field. That pitch swung on and missed, and it's strike one to Dykstra. The hit by Christensen, only the second of the game for the Jayhawks. Now the 0-1. Down and in, one ball, one strike. Drew Dykstra with a neon yellow and black bat in his hands, white batting gloves. Urbandale with white batting helmets. Again, those navy jerseys and their white pants. The 1-1. I guess a little high, 2-1. Thomason trying to make sure that German at first can't get too big of a lead, get a running start. The three-run lead right now, though, would like to see him make a good pitch here, the 2-1. There's a strike, 2-2. That looked almost identical to the previous pitch, but we'll take strike two. Two balls, two strikes, one on, one out, bottom five. Ottumwa leading 4-1. The 2-2 pitch, grounded softly foul off to the right, and we'll do it again. Urbandale has some very good individual hitters. Foremost among them being the man on deck, Dylan Cool. They only hit 279 as a team, though. It's not bad, but, you know, we've seen a lot of teams we said were just decent hitting at 300 or better. The 2-2. Swing and a miss, strike three. Runner going, throw down to second is wide. Gets into center field, but backed up by McKinnon. And Dennison a little bit frustrated. A good throw might have gotten them a strike, him out, throw him out, double play. It is out number two. was. Caleb German picks up his second stolen base. Pardon me, his third stolen base of the year. And now Dylan Kuhl is grounded to short and lined to center. And Kuhl is their big threat. Thomason calls time. He wants some water brought out. On this 100-degree day, you're allowed a water break as he talks to the base umpire. First base is open. Kuhl hitting .388 coming in, four home runs, 26 runs batted in. The man on deck, Sam Harris, hitting .314, two home runs, 16 driven in. So they're both run producers, but Kuhl is the bigger threat. Although having said that, if you were to pitch around him here, Harris would represent the tying run. First pitch, strike at the knees, 0-1. If you make good pitches, though, you can get Kuhl if you're Max Thomason, and he has retired him twice. Runner at second, two down, Ottumwa leading 4-1, bottom five. Another turning point here, perhaps. The 0-1. Breaking ball off the plate, one ball, one strike. One and one to Kuhl, K-U-E-H-L. The pitch, high, 2-1. Two and one to the Urbandale left-handed slugger. Thomason's pitch, fouled back, 2-2. Thomason a strike away from getting out of the fifth inning with a three-run lead intact. Bulldogs ahead 4-1. I look back at second, the 2-2. Just off the plate, 3-2. Bulldog fans thought it was strike three. Mitch Wood out short thought it was strike three. He was headed to the dugout. 3-2 again. First base open. You don't have to throw this down the middle. The 3-2. Fly ball to right, well hit. Going back, Rominger looking up. That ball is gone. That's the one thing he didn't want to do. A two-run homer, the fifth of the year for Kuhl, and it's a one-run game, 4-3. Well, Ottumwa still got the lead, but now it's going to be edge of your seat time for the final two-plus innings. And you're not out of the woods yet. Here's Sam Harris, who's reached on an error and singled 1-for-2. Righty to lefty. Thomason's pitch. Over below, ball one. Heard somebody say the wind has died down a little bit, and maybe that was a factor in that ball getting over the fence. The 1-0, way outside, 2-0. Well, it's a game of inches. Ottumwa thought they had the strikeout on the 2-2 pitch, didn't get the call, then the next pitch leaves the yard. The 2-0 here to Harris. There's a fly ball to center, well hit. McKinnon going back. And that ball is gone, and we're tied on back-to-back homers. Third of the year for Harris, his 17th RBI. Well, yesterday Ottumwa hit back-to-back homers, and they broke open the game against Roosevelt. Here they give up back-to-back homers and lose a three-run lead. First pitch is a strike to Dawson Roberts, 0-1. Roberts has walked and lined to right. Now the 0-1. Breaking ball drops low, 1-1. Thomason winds and delivers, and it's off the plate outside, 2-1. Boy, this zone was big the first two innings, and it's been shrinking ever since. That pitch in there for a strike, and it's 2-2. Thomason's 2-2, off the plate outside, 3-2. Jalen Ziegler on deck. Jackson Saunders is now throwing in the Ottumwa pen. The 3-2. Chopper high in the air over Thomason. Mitch Woodfield's at short, throws not in time. An infield hit for Roberts. We'll keep the inning going for Ziegler, who has walked and popped out 0-1. And pitching coach Luke Gomad will come out to talk to his starter. This inning started innocently enough, a ground ball to first by Tronson. Christensen singled. He stole second as Dykstra was striking out, and then Thomason got to 2-2 on Dylan Cool. Threw a pitch he thought was strike three but was called a ball. The next pitch was hit out of the park for a home run. Then he threw 2 balls to Sam Harris, and the next pitch after that hit over the fence in center for a game-tying homer. Now the infield single by Roberts has brought Ziegler to the plate. And Luke Gomat to the mound to just try to talk his starter through one more out in this fifth inning. Ottumwa's got the top of the order coming up in the sixth, so an opportunity to get right back in front, but you don't want to fall behind. Conference is over, and Ziegler will stand in, right-handed batter. Each team 4 runs, 5 hits, 2 errors now. Thomason's pitch, outside, 1-1. Snap throw down to first, not in time, close play. 1-0 to Ziegler. That was a design play, kind of a pseudo pitch out there. Tomo tried to steal the third out and catch Urbandale napping. It came close to working. Now the 1-0. High 2-0. Well, you get the feeling that if Thomason cannot retire Ziegler, he won't hang in there to face Dylan Sams. They'll bring on Saunders. Yeah. 2-0 the count, the pitch. Popped it up. Calling for it right near the plate is Denniston. The catcher makes the play, and the side is retired. But Urbandale gets 3 runs on 4 hits, back-to-back homers. They leave one, but they tie the game at 4 as we go to the 6th inning on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Seasons change. Our priorities change. Your financial needs change. But there's one thing that remains consistent. Our dedication to making your financial life easier. Together. So let's get to know each other. Because together is better.
You're watching the Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Top of the sixth inning, Bulldog Baseball brought to you by Cole Palace Cafe and Books on West Main Street. It's home by the Train Depot, offering an array of coffee beverages. They also serve breakfast, and they have homemade soup, salads, and sandwiches for lunch. For more information, like and follow them on Facebook. By Blackhawk Auto Body and Linex of Ottumwa for all your auto body repair needs, insurance work, and spray-in bedliners. Check them out for all your aftermarket truck accessories. Contact Blackhawk Auto Body for a free quote. And by Lee's Photography in Ottumwa, capturing all the special moments in your life, such as weddings, sports, senior photos, family portraits, and more. Lee's Photography on East 2nd Street across from the Courier in Ottumwa, capturing memories to last a lifetime. Blaze Rominger leads off the top of the sixth and takes ball one from Colin Perez, a brand new ball game. We are tied at four after a three spot from Urbandale in the bottom of the fifth. Now the 1-0 is in the dirt and the count goes to two balls and no strikes. The 2-0 from Perez is high and inside 3-0, and we said he's issued 10 walks on the season coming in. We hadn't really seen the wildness, but if he walks Rominger in front of Mitch Wood, you like your chances. The 3-0, letter high strike 3-1, Blaze taking all the way. The 3-1 offering, high ball four. And there's a good start, leadoff man on. Ottumwa did get the leadoff man on last inning. Could not bring him around, eventually stranding Carter Thompson at second.
Now batting the shortstop, Mitch Wood.
When did they get back?
Wood is 1-for-3 with an RBI single. He missed a grand slam by a few feet his last time up, flying out to deep left. Ended the third inning. Be a much different game if that ball had gone out. First pitch here, breaking ball lined just off the tip of the third baseman, Roberts' glove into left field for a single, and it's two on, nobody out. Sixth hit of the game for the Dogs, second for Wood, and Jesus Jaime batting with two on and nobody out. He's 1-for-3 with a double, reached on an error, and he struck out against Perez last time on three breaking balls. Boy, Roberts, I thought that ball would be well over his head. He got way up in the air, got the tip of his glove on it, but that was all. First pitch. A little bit high, ball one. One and oh to Zeus. Rominger at second, Wood at first, nobody out, the pitch. Strike at the knees, 1-1. Bulldog fans are keep thinking that pitch around the knees is too low. 1-1 to Zeus. The next offering. High fly ball deep to left, but there's room underneath it for Heinen to make the catch for out number one as he drifted towards the foul pole. I think Jaime just missed it. So here's Adam Greiner. 1-for-3 with a single, robbed of a second hit on a diving catch by the right fielder Ziegler in the second inning. Griner's found success recently going the opposite way. That was his infield hit in the first inning. That was nearly his second hit in the second inning. He popped out to second his last time up. First and second, now one away for Ottumwa here in the top of the sixth. The pitch. Poked in the air, foul off to the right, out of play, 0-1. Adam stepped out for a moment. Now digs back in with the blue bat in his hands, red and white batting gloves on his hands. The 0-1. Runners go, pitch a high chopper to third. Waiting on it is Roberts. Long throw across the diamond is in time for out number two, but the runners do advance to second and third. And it's up to Trey Swartz, who is 0-for-2 with a walk and a run scored.
The first baseman, Trey Swartz.
Second and third. Two down, top six, tied at four. Big moment here. First pitch on the way. High ball one. Rominger walked to lead off the inning. Woods singled. Jaime flied out to deep left. Grinder grounded out with the runners in motion. They're now at second and third. The 1-0. Popped up. Back behind the plate. Could be room for Christensen, and the catcher will make the play to retire the side. Ottumwa got the first two men on, one hit, but they'll leave them in scoring position. We go to the bottom of the sixth. Ottumwa 4, Urbandale 4 on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Are you looking for someone to capture the special moments in life, such as senior photos, weddings, family portraits, baby pictures, or even your furry friends? Look no further than Lee's Photography in Ottumwa to schedule your appointment. Brian, Connie, and the staff at Lee's Photography have the knowledge and experience to capture your special moments and make your vision come to life. Visit them on Facebook to see the range of their work. Lee's Photography on East 2nd Street, across from the Courier in Ottumwa, for all your all-around photography needs.
You're watching the Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network. I do it for the love.
Bottom of the sixth inning. Ottumwa 4. Urbandale 4, and the Bulldogs will go to the pen for Jackson Saunders in relief of Max Thomason. Thomason will get a no decision today. We'll work on his line in a moment. Jackson Saunders making his fifth appearance, no record, two saves, no ERA. Four and a third innings pitch, just one hit allowed, three walks, one hit batter, two strikeouts. Opponents hitting 0-56 against the senior. Saunders and Wood, Mitch Wood, are Ottumwa's two top relievers. And Saunders will face 7-8-9 in the Urbandale order, Sams, Heinen, and Tronson. Dylan Sams has bounced into a fielder's choice and flied out to center. Wind up by Saunders and the pitch. Outside, ball one. The 1-0 is downstairs, and Saunders falls behind Sam's 2-0. The 2-0 pitch, chopper third base side foul, and it's 2-1. Two balls, one strike. Next offering from Saunders. On the outside corner, strike two. Saunders has worked it back even. And now the 2-2 pitch. Sails up and in, 3-2. The line on Max Thomason, five innings pitched, four runs, three earned on five hits, one walk, three strikeouts, 87 pitches, no decision. Feels like an important pitch here. The 3-2. And he put it in the dirt, ball four. Lead off. Each team has gotten a leadoff walk to start the sixth inning in a tie game. Ottumwa could not take advantage. Reese Hine in the battery struck out twice, hitting under 100 on the season. You would think he would be bunting here. Sams gets his lead at first. Bunt shown, the pitch. In the dirt, snap throw down to first, the tag, not in time. And it's 1-0 to Heinen. Saunders got to throw strikes here. Yeah, 1-0 the count to the Jayhawk left fielder. The pitch, bunted in the air back to the screen. Count evens at a ball and a strike. One and one the count to Reese Heinen. Saunders from the stretch, bunt shown very early, the pitch. In the dirt, and it went back to Saunders, but down to second on a very wild pitch goes Sams. Count is 2-1. That's the second wild pitch in a Ottumwa pitcher's thrown that has bounced back towards the mound. And we've got somebody stretching in the Ottumwa bullpen, trying to get loose in a hurry. They're still trying to bunt here. The pitch, bunted back to the mound. They'll look the runner back to second, throw to first. Now he stumbles, throw to third. Oh, it got away from Jaime down into the bullpen, and the run will score. Ottumwa was going to get a double play there, but it's thrown away, and Urbandale leads 5-4. Wow. Sams got hung up between second and third. He should have gone back to second once he stopped. Saunders threw to first to get Heinen. And then Sams tried to run to third, stumbled, and the throw from Swartz to Jaime had him beat, but it bounced away. Now Tronson, the batter, he bunts it left side, fielded by Saunders, throw to first is low, and it gets away. Racing for second is Tronson. Throw to second, not in time. We'll see how that one scored. Scoreboard showing nobody out. There is one out. Heinen was out at first. It was a throwing error by Swartz that allowed the run to score, an unearned run. And that's a two-base error on Saunders. Ottumwa has fallen behind. Literally, they've thrown it away here. Now the top of the order, Christensen, who's 1-for-3 with a single. Runner at second, still only one out. The pitch, upstairs, ball one. Scoreboard says 6-4. It's only 5-4. Ottumwa's only down one run. And that pitch skied in the air to left center. That ball's tailing away, but Shark will get there. It was tailing away from McKinnon, but Tanner Shark, the left fielder, makes the catch in the alley for out number two. And the batter will be Drew Dykstra. Dykstra's 0-for-3 of the flyout, a pop out, and a strikeout. Hopefully both teams realize that the scoreboard is incorrect. It is 5-4 Urbandale, not 6-4. Now they've corrected it. And that pitch came in and it hit Dykstra in the leg, and that's not what Saunders wanted, because here comes Dylan Cool, whose two-run homer was the first big blow of the fifth inning. That made it a one-run game, before Sam Harris tied it with the back-to-back homer. Cool had grounded out and lined out before the home run. And he's got a chance to break it open here. It's Julian Moore warming up for Ottumwa. But right now, the game is really in the hands of Saunders and Cool. First and second, two down. The pitch, down and in, ball one. Want to know the count to the left-handed batting designated hitter. The next pitch. Upstairs, 2-0. balls, no strikes. A hitter's count for Dylan Cool. The pitch. Downstairs 3-0. Saunders just has not had his control in this outing. A bad time for it. 3 balls, no strikes. The pitch. Cool taking all the way. That ball caught the plate for strike one. Three and one the count. And the pitch. Swing and a miss, 3-2, and Cool was trying to hit that one over the scoreboard. Well, the runners will be in motion. 3 balls, 2 strikes, first and second, 2 down. There they go. The pitch lined into center, base hit. Around third is Tronson. He will score. Going first to third is Dykstra, and it is 6-4. Two unearned runs in the inning. And Sam Harris due up 2 for 3 of the single and the home run that tied the game in the fifth. Urbandale wants a pinch runner for Cool. Caleb German will be that pinch runner. And Harris will stand in against, looks like it'll still be Saunders. First and third, 2 down. Got to get out of this inning, give yourself a chance in the top of the seventh. Pitch up high, ball one. And this inning all turned when Ottumwa threw away what would have been a double play. The 1-0. Up high, 2-0. Urbandale had a man at second, nobody out. They tried to bunt him to third. The bunt was too strong. Saunders was able to look the runner back to second and throw to first for the out. The runner, Sams, then tried to go to third and fell down, and Trey Schwartz's throw back to third would have been in plenty of time, but he threw it away, and that scored the go-ahead run. Check swing, boy. It looked like he went around, and yes, the base umpire says he did on appeal, 2-1 to Harris. Two balls, one strike. Righty to lefty, Saunders pitch. Swing and a miss, 2-2. Ottumwa will have Thompson, the pitcher spot, and Shark do up in the top of the seventh. So they'll need to get some guys on base to get Wood and Jaime another try. Saunders will step off the rubber. Still 2-2 to Sam Harris. The pitch. And they called a balk on Saunders, and he knows it. And it is 7-4. Pitch doesn't count. Dykstra scores. German the second. Boy, Ottumwa had a 4-1 lead going to the bottom of the fifth, had a 4-1 lead with two out in the bottom of the fifth. And there is a pop foul out of play to the right. We stay at 2-2. All the runs in this inning are unearned, but that's cold comfort to Jackson Saunders right now. The pitch. Breaking ball called, strike three, and the inning mercifully comes to an end. Urbandale tacks on 3 more runs On only one hit, there were two critical errors and two left on base. We go to the top of the seventh. Ottumwa needs three to tie, four to take the lead. It is 7-4 Urbandale on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
It's time to choose the credit union with a new perspective. At Meridian Credit Union, we don't just see member profiles. We see people. People with goals. People who want to save more. People that we can help. That's why we offer financial services convenient to you. Great loan rates, online banking with bill pay, mobile banking, and credit cards. Join the many satisfied Meridian members today. See how our perspective can help you.
Meridian Credit Union, where it feels like home.
You're watching the Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
I did not come to play, I came to dominate. Dominate.
Top of the seventh inning. Hard to believe I'm saying this, but Ottumwa down, pardon me, down to its last chance in game one. Now trailing Urbandale 7-4. Urbandale will turn to Sam Harris. They bring in their first baseman to pitch the seventh. Dylan Cool, who had been the DH, moves to first base. Harris, a sophomore, is making his fifth appearance. He's 0-1. He has a save, a 2.62 ERA, 5 1/3 innings pitched, 3 hits allowed, 2 runs both earned, 1 walk, 1 hit batter, 10 strikeouts. Opponents hitting just 176 against him. Carter Thompson leads it off. He's 1-for-2 with a single and a sacrifice. The pitch, pop foul out of play for strike one. Miles Sainer has grabbed a bat. He is on deck in the spot that was occupied by Jackson Saunders. The 0-1 to Thompson. Downstairs, 1-1. Next offering a fastball in there for a strike, and Thompson down in the count 1-2. And a swing and a miss, strike three for out number one. So here is Sainer pinch hitting for Saunders. The junior hitting .312, a couple of doubles, and 4 runs batted in. Ottumwa down 7-4. Each team has 6 hits. As that pitch is in there for a strike, 0-1, Ottumwa's committed 4 errors. 2 in the second inning that led to a run, 2 more in the sixth inning that led to 3 runs. That pitch is a strike, 0-2, and if Ottumwa had been able to get that unconventional double play, they wouldn't have given up anything in the sixth. Even if Tronson had reached on the bunt, Christensen flied out to center, that would have done it. The 0-2, called strike 3. Sainer can't believe it. That strike zone got lower. And Ottumwa down to its final strike, or out, final out, pardon me, Tanner Shark. He's walked twice and popped out 0-for-1. Two out, nobody on. We're at the number 8 spot in the batting order. Lefty to lefty, and a big swing and a miss by Tanner at a high fastball, 0-1. You want to think positive. If the next 3 guys get on, you could load the bases for Mitch Wood. Here's the 0-1. In there for a strike, and now Ottumwa down to its final strike, 0-2. Well, this will be a bitter pill to swallow. Ottumwa led this game from the second inning on until the fifth. The 0-2. High chopper, slowly left side. Could be a tough play. Third baseman Roberts cuts in front. Throw to first is in time. And game one is in the books. Ottumwa sees its 9-game win streak snapped, and they kind of give it away themselves, falling 7-4 to number 10 Urbandale. We'll take 3 minutes, come back, and get the game one totals on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Schroeder Graphics and Signs, LLC, across the road from RJ Performance, is your go-to headquarters for all things custom designed, including vehicle wraps, printing, signs, billboards, and state-of-the-art commercial lighted signs. They also do window designs, semis, and VIN DOTs, wall designs, any size of coolers, customized bag boards, custom trailers, tumblers, race cars, go-karts, off-road vehicles, and more. Realtors, contact them for your custom yard signs, too. Visit sgsignsllc.com and like them on Facebook. Schroeder Graphics, be a brand above.
Hi, I'm Dr. Dwayne Petrito, your orthodontist in Ottumwa and Oskaloosa. Many of our patients are playing in this game, and we want you to know we are happy to see you representing your school and playing hard. If you haven't been in to see us yet, please call our office for an appointment. Your first appointment is always free. From start to finish, we are here for you every step of the way. We specialize in giving you a great smile and bite. We look forward to seeing you soon. Our team is cheering for you in today's game.
Seasons change. Our priorities change. Your financial needs change. But there's one thing that remains consistent. Our dedication to making your financial life easier together. So let's get to know each other. Because together is better.
Cole Palace Cafe and Books invites you to stop in and try their real, not fast, fresh, never frozen, made-in-house menu, which is sure to satisfy. Start your day with their fresh brewed coffee or one of their specialty drinks and a delicious breakfast. Stop in for a cup of one of their homemade soups, a sandwich, or salad for lunch. Don't forget dessert. At Cole Palace Cafe and Books, your purchases help our neighbors with disabilities learn valuable job skills. Check out their gently used books while you wait. That's Cole Palace Cafe and Books at 226 West Main Street, Ottumwa.
Hi, this is Vince Tyson, General Manager with Citizens Mutual in Bloomfield, the area's premier broadband provider. Wapello County, we have heard your screams of frustration. You need reliable internet, and we are proud to expand high-speed fiber internet into Wapello County. Express your interest today by going to findmyfiber.mycmtech.com. Again, that's findmyfiber.mycmtech.com. We look forward to hearing from you and bringing you the very best internet service at Citizens Mutual, coming soon to Wapello County.
It's time to choose the credit union with a new perspective. At Meridian Credit Union, we don't just see member profiles. We see people. People with goals. People who want to save more. People that we can help. That's why we offer financial services convenient to you. Great loan rates, online banking with bill pay, mobile banking, and credit cards. Join the many satisfied Meridian members today. See how our perspective can help you.
Meridian Credit Union, where it feels like home.
You're watching the Ottumwa Bulldogs on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Well, that was a tough one, Ottumwa fans. The Bulldogs came out fired up against number 10 Urbandale in game one of our doubleheader today. Had a 3-0 lead after the top of the second, a 4-1 lead after three, but that lead evaporated with two outs in the fifth on back-to-back homers, and then Ottumwa committed a couple of critical errors in the sixth inning, opened the door for a three-run frame that proved to be the difference as Urbandale wins at 7-4. The game one totals for the Jayhawks, 7 runs, 6 hits, 2 errors, 7 left on base. Colin Perez gets the win in relief. He's 3-0. Sam Harris earns his second save. For Ottumwa, 4 runs, 6 hits, 4 errors. They left 8 on base. Jackson Saunders, the loss in relief, 0-1 in a ballgame that took 1 hour and 51 minutes to complete. Ottumwa falls to 16-4. Urbandale improves to 12-7. Bulldogs can still get a win over the number 10 Jayhawks in the nightcap, so their hope now is to get out of here with a split before they get ready for their long trip to South Winneshiek on Saturday. So right now on the radio side, we'll take a 3-minute timeout, then get you an update from Radio Iowa News, Radio Iowa Sports. On the video side, a few more words from our great sponsors, and then we'll just sit back, relax, and get ready for game two here at Barton Field in Urbandale. Ottumwa drops game one 7-4. They'll go for the split shortly, so keep it right here on the Ottumwa Radio Sports Network.
Hi, I'm Mark Freimwehr, new owner of Champion Bowl in Ottumwa, Iowa. Call us at Champion Bowl to join the fun. We have new hours to better serve you. We are open Monday through Thursday, 10 a.m. to 10 p.m., Friday and Saturday, 10 a.m. to midnight, and noon to 10 every Sunday. If you just want to hang out in the lounge, we have a full bar and a great menu. Make sure and like us on Facebook for weekly fun and special at Champion Bowl in Ottumwa, where bowling is fun.
Seasons change. Our priorities change. Your financial needs change. But there's one thing that remains consistent. Our dedication to making your financial life easier. Together. So let's get to know each other. Because together is better.